What is up, guys? It's your boy, No Risk, No Premium, back with another episode of the Market Overview, guys. Today we went back right back into that zone and tested that same 45-60 area. If you're about as frustrated as I think everybody else is in this range, you're not alone. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and say that. Really, since that CPI pump, we've been up in this general area for about 3 weeks now. We're going on a month here. So yes, it is getting very tactical, is getting very tough trading. You almost can't believe every time. I mean, how many dips have been bought here? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. I mean, it's just, you're getting almost, it's almost unbelievable, right? But that's what the chart is telling us. So we're going to start sounding pretty redundant here. I mean, it's going to, you know, we're gonna be saying the same thing over and over, like a broken record. Well, we're gonna look at buying this dip right into this area here, 45, 45-40 to 45-60, right? It's getting pretty redundant, but nonetheless, I do think we will break out of that range soon. We do have a lot of data prints coming out next week. Hopefully, it's not next week, but we'll see. What can we control? What can we look for to tomorrow? Tomorrow, we have some data in the pre-market. As you can see, I got to scroll down. Why is my mouse doing that? Got to scroll down here. Got the ISM, all that ISM data, economic optimism outlook is at 10 a.m. And then we have the JOLTS data tomorrow. So that'll be interesting. Tomorrow we got a good amount of data coming out at 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Really nothing coming out in the pre-market. So just data 30 minutes in. Just add a 30 minutes into the market open, as you can see here. That's all we really have to worry about for tomorrow. So let's take a look at the charts here. Like I said, things are going to get rather repetitive for the market here. As you can see, we are making higher highs and higher lows, very soft, very slowly, but we are. So 45.6 is going to be my area I'm going to watch tomorrow. 4600. This is going to be the gap in a range you're going to want to watch. I do think under 45.60, you can watch 45.40. I don't like the short setup unless we get underneath about 45.37, 45.38. You guys can see 45.40. I'd want to break below, back test, and then 4500 to 4509 would be that next range down, where I'd be looking underneath there. But until then, it's going to be buy the dip mode as long as we are above about 45.40 to 45.35. So 45.6 would be that big overnight level. Watch 4600 to the upside from here. Onto the SPY chart. I like the daily chart just a little bit better. As you can see, almost put in an inside day. But we've got to zoom out and look left so we can see what's going on in this area. We're pretty much at 52-week highs. 460 is going to be this big level. I mean, we're holding 453. 453 is holding. As long as this 453 area holds, get back above. Like to see a move through this 457 area that we basically got stuck at today. So tomorrow, let's watch 457. Break and hold above that. Likely come up and see this 460 area. If we can break above 457, you guys can see we spent all day pretty much just ranging below that level. 453 will be my long area, all the way down to 451. 448 is the next bounce area under 451. Gap fill from 446 all the way to 440. If we get down there, that's if we get down there. But for tomorrow, let's watch 457. Let's see how we react there. 453, as long as that's holding, we're going to look to buy the dip into that area. I do think there is a short setup under there, which would take us down to 451 if we break and hold on 453 to the downside. QQQ. Let's take a peek at the Qs. Qs went into its gap just a tad here. So I have to fix this, right? This gap from a little while ago, but went into this gap area. Let's, right. But still, this 383.50-ish zone, we can really actually just activate this. We can take this down just a little bit right to that gap fill. But you can see 383, right? 383 is going to be that level it wants to hold. I don't like how zoomed in this is. Hold on 1 second. There we go. Okay, nonetheless, though, pretty much putting in a big hammer wick to the downside. So as long as we open up above 386, right? Because this 386 was the previous week low here, right? We held that area at the close here. So let's see, we open above that, look for dips into this area 386 to take us back to 388, 390, 394 is going to be above there. I only think the short setup now is either up here at 394, or if we break below 383 or 382.50-ish, and we go to gap fill, 383, 78.50 should be your bounce zones. Gap fill bounce at 378.50, I would definitely be looking at. But as for tomorrow, let's watch this here. We open. If we open up above this 386, can look for dips into there to take us back above 388, 390. From there, IWM, that's not how you spell that. That's how you spell that. This thing is booting, scooting, tooting to the upside. I mean, just nice big candles to the upside here on IWM. Looks like we had a rotation. I mean, if you look, it was SPYs down, QQQ down, IWM up. So is money going into the small caps? It looks like it, right? It looks like it. So if we have a profit taking days, I mean, money goes back into SPY and QQQ. It's very possible. Just want to watch to see if that rotation is going to happen. But we've got this 188 level up above. Look to see what happens in the overnight. But I like to see this 192 possibly come from the end of this run up to the upside. I would like to look for the possible reject at 192 up here. I would like to see if we get a back test too. I like the long back test of this double top that we had right here at 182. 182 would be a back test. I'd look for the longs in that zone, or a move through 188 to 192. Want to talk about individual name here, Apple. Apple still setting up very nicely, right? Still set up very nicely in this bull flag. Right now, I think tomorrow the game plan is going to be, if we're above 190, break and hold 192 at the upside, bull flag on 192, 194 from there, right? 192, 194. That's what I'll be looking at, the break and hold of 190 to the upside on Apple for this bull flag to play out. And then last but not least, I'm gonna look at I'm gonna look at AM Dizzle for Shizzle. Putting in a wick down, right? Holding 116. As long as dips into about 116 hold, that's great. Or if we take out 120. Take out 120 to the upside is today's high. I would like to see a break and hold above 120 to the upside, opens up 122 all the way up to 124 from there. So 116 bounce or break and hold 119 to about 120, 119.50 to 120 to the upside. That'll be two great trades I'll be looking for IWM. Sorry, IWM. For AMD, you guys have to apologize. I'm adding tickers to the end of this. Usually the last ticker I was doing for however many months now has been IWM. So my apologies. This is AMD. Guys, that's all I got for you. Pay attention to the data that comes out 30 minutes into the market open tomorrow. And other than that, you got to wake up early, get your levels right, and of course, not do anything fucking stupid. We'll see you bright and early. Peace.